Ellarigu namaskara, welcome and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be an empties video. So I had another batch of empties that I did film, which was lost in that footage that I lost previously, which I've told you guys 1,000 times about. So it was majorly like shampoos and baths and skincare products. It was majorly that. So this time, however, we have a lot of makeup as well. So without further ado, let's get started with the video. As always, I have my trusty old garbage bag here with me, a good old friend where I'm going to throw all the garbage in it. Let's fill this baby up. So let's just begin. So first, I have this vanilla body butter from Health and Glow. As you can tell, I still have quite more than like, I would say half left in this, but the thing is this expired, so I do have to throw it away because it has a funky smell. When I initially got it, it was like almost 2.5 years back. It was smelling so good. I wish I had used it up, but I forgot about it. But this is a really nice body butter. However, I wouldn't purchase it just because it takes a very long time to sink into my skin. I found better body butters over time. So yeah. Next up is this Himalaya anti-dandruff cream, my favorite, will always repurchase. I've completely used up. I have a video that shows how you can use it as well. I will always have this in my connection. I've already purchased another one and I've started using it as well. So yeah, that's that. I love that. And then I have this Nivea soft light moisturizer. Again, I love the tub of this, and I like this particularly in summer because it is light moisturizer, like it claims, and it sinks into the skin like this, like very quickly. So it does do the job like it says. It is a light moisturizer. It moisturizes the body. It's very good. I would definitely repurchase this, but this will be a summer staple. Next up, I have this Biomargoza anti-dandruff shampoo and conditioner. If you guys have been watching any of my recent videos, you guys know that Patanjali Keshkanti hair cleanser and I, we broke up. We are so done. Now I found something way better. This is the anti-dandruff shampoo and a shampoo and conditioner. I love this not only because it keeps my dandruff at bay, like I don't get dandruff at all these days. The other reason why I love it is because it makes my hair a lot more manageable. Like this is with that shampoo, no hair straightener, no blow dry, no nothing. And my hair texture has improved so much since using this shampoo. The best part is that this is like vegan and chemical free and you know all those good things. This is also that, and I just love it. This is just for 99 rupees, and this is like, this says it is 100% Ayurvedic recipe. And this smell is very similar to that of the D-free anti-dandruff lotion shampoo. I have to check the ingredients to see if they have the same or similar ingredients, because it smells very similar. But if you guys have dandruff, I would suggest you guys to check this out. I have already purchased like a big bottle of it, and I have a smaller bottle that I purchased with this. I will always have this shampoo until I find a better one, but until then, this one is the bomb. And then I have this Nivea Care Shower Cream Soft Shower Gel. This is the almond scented one. I think I have now decided that from now on, if I buy a shower gel, it is going to be only from Body Shop, because I've tried the British Rose one and I am absolutely in love with it. Like, I want a shower 24/7 because I'll get to use that shower in my shower gel. I mean, shower gel in my shower. That's how much I love that shower gel, and I've smelled many others. The only two scents that I don't like, I don't know if they're two different scents or the same scents. I don't like the olive oil one and the green tea one. Apart from that, everyone smell so good. I love it. This will be there. I mean, I will still purchase Nivea and Palmolive and all that when I don't have time or access to Body Shop. Otherwise, I think I am going to switch over to Body Shop now. It's like 345 rupees, and it does last like really well. This one lasts like a month or 5-6 weeks max, so I think even that lasts pretty much the same amount of time. Oh, I didn't realize I have a lot of Nivea stuff in here. That's very funny. And then I have my favorite primer of all time. This is the Nivea Post Shave Men's Balm. Yes, I've kept it in the plastic container. This is completely empty. I hate the plastic container of this, but I love it. This is my daily moisturizer, by the way. This is the only thing in winter that has kept my skin in good condition. I moisturize with this every single day because of the amount of glycerin it has in it. It gives my skin like this natural dewy look without making it look greasy or anything. It gets absorbed in the skin very nicely. And trust me, you guys, in the sunlight, like I've said in many videos, I don't wear any makeup to work. I don't wear any face makeup. I just put eyeliner, mascara, lipstick, and that's about it. And when I take pictures in the sunlight, my skin literally glows. And this, it's only because of this one. This is not only a great primer but also a great moisturizer. Highly recommend. I've already repurchased it and I've used I think at least half of it. That's like my favorite primer. And I've started to realize I like primers that are hydrating and nourishing and replenish my skin rather than something that would make my pores look smaller or that would make my makeup last longer. I mean, I would rather have something hydrating because I love the way the foundation or whatever I put on top, the way it sits on my skin is really beautiful, if I say so myself. So yeah. And then I have another shower gel here. This is the Nivea Care Shower Frangipani and Oil Shower Gel. What does this smell like? Okay, it does smell really nice, but like I said, I switched over to Body Shop from now on. I'm just gonna stick to Body Shop. And then I have this D-Free Overnight Anti-Dandruff Lotion. This is the medium variant, I think. You guys, this stuff works. Overnight, yeah, it does work. Like it claims it does, but the only gripe that I have with this is that this size bottle will last you maybe 2, maximum 3 uses. That's my only gripe. And this one is for like 110 rupees, this size. So the size is pretty small. You do use up a lot of it. And this is not a permanent cure by any means. It will, your dandruff will still come back if you do not maintain your hair in proper condition. But I use this only at times when I think that my hair or my dandruff has gone to absolute shit and I need some instant treatment. This does the job. So for daily or weekly use for your hair, I wouldn't suggest this. But if you're using this like as a treatment solution once in a while and something that you want immediate results with, this does work. I've used the D-Free Anti-Dandruff Lotion in conjunction with my Bio Margosa Anti-Dandruff Shampoo and Conditioner, and that has kept my hair in good condition. Touch wood, it's kept in very good condition, I would say. So yeah, give it a go. And the rest of it is all makeup. So first up, I have like 4 mascaras. Okay, let's talk about this. This is the Blue Heaven Sketch Eyeliner Pen. I mean, this does still have some left, but yeah, I mean, it's gone. You can see. Why is there product coming out now? Oh, wow, there's still a lot of product in it. I never realized. Because when I was trying to draw, it did look empty. Okay, so I'm going to keep it aside. Maybe you'll see this in my next empties video. But the Blue Heaven Sketch Eyeliner Pen is my favorite eyeliner. Hands down, like sketch eyeliner pen ever. It's smudge-proof, waterproof. Love it. And then I have one lip balm. This is the Nivea Lip Moisturizer. You can see there's still some left, but that's just like the Vaseline that is sticking to the plastic portion. This was good, but I like my Nivea one better because it's very intensely moisturizing. This one, not so much, especially if you are the kind of person who wears matte lipsticks all the freaking time. You won't like it because it's not that thick and hydrating. The Nivea one, the best. I still have another tube of the Neutrogena one, which I will still use up. But the Nivea one is my favorite. And then I have 2 lip products here. And I'm throwing both of these away because these have expired. Let me show you swatches. The first one is the L18 ColourPop's lipstick in the shade Coral Romance. Smells funky. I love this color. Not for my lips. I love this as a color corrector. This is like the perfect tone for color correction if you are someone with my skin tone. It cancels out any sort of pigmentation. It doesn't move once you put concealer on top. It's really, really good, but I'm so sad to throw it away because, you know, it expired, so I do have to throw it away. But I really did like it. But now I'm using the L18 ColourPop's matte lipstick in the shade Coral Dose. That's again an orange color, and since it's matte, it's even better than this one. This sort of had like this dewy finish underneath, but that one is completely matte, so it's even better. And the other lipstick that I'm throwing away is the Unt Cosmetics lipstick, and this is in the shade VL20. The only reason why I'm throwing this away because it is starting to smell funky. Oh yeah, it smells like a fish market. Yeah, it smells exactly like that. This lipstick I absolutely loved. This is very comparable to the Sephora cream lip stains, and the color, gorgeous. Look at that color. You're so gorgeous. Have you guys heard that song? So it's a very beautiful color. Unfortunately, I think it is expired, or I don't know what's up with it, but this was actually sent to me for review and I've been using it for a good year now, and it stinks, so I'm not gonna put this on my lips at all. That's why I have to throw it away. I'm so sad. I love this lipstick, one of my favorite lipsticks. And then we have four mascaras to talk about, and that's about it. So first, let's talk about this one. This is the Dazzler mascara. You can see how worn off it is. This one was very cheap, and this is what the wand looks like. This is, let's be real, jack shit. Does nothing to your lashes. If anything, it transfers the mascara onto your top lash line, which is something none of us want. So I don't like it. The only thing that I like is the smell, which is also gone now. It used to smell like camphor, and it is also pretty old, so I'm throwing it away. And then I have two essence mascaras, which was in my disappointing products video, and these have been completely used up. Like I said in the video, I think I got like a half empty tube or like a used up tube, and that's why I couldn't find any product on the bristles. But I liked using this with the Maybelline Push Up Drama mascara as well as the Lash Sensational, because this did not have any product. It helped in separating the lashes, and it also added a very subtle tint to my lower lashes, which I liked. So this is the Essence Get Big Lashes 3 Triple Black Mascara, and this is the Essence Get Big Lashes Volume Boost Waterproof Mascara. Both of these did jack shit to my lashes alone, but in combination with some Maybelline mascaras, they worked well. I mean, I could make them work. Let's just leave it at that. So many of you guys said that this worked so well for you. Maybe you guys got a nice tube or a good batch and I got a bad one. I don't know what's what, so let's see. And the last is this is the this is the Maybelline New York The Falsies Push Up Drama mascara. I absolutely love this mascara. Like I said, every time I wear this mascara, I mean, I used to wear this mascara to work every single day, and I get questions on a daily basis asking if I'm wearing fake lashes. I am not kidding. I wear only one coat of this mascara and then put one of those essence mascaras on top, which does nothing to my lashes except separating them. But this just awakens your lashes like this. It curls them. Normally, I don't curl my lashes for work as well. I just put mascara straight up, and this is so good. This is the washable variant, which I don't like that much. I like the waterproof variant the best, but still, if you like the washable variant, you could give it a shot. This mascara gives you length. It gives you a lot of length. Like, your lashes will like double in size, and I'm not exaggerating. This is that good. I will repurchase this, but I have other mascaras that I need to go through. Once I'm done with that, I think I'll only be switching between the Lash Sensational as well as the Push Up Drama mascara, because those two are like the best. So with that, this trash bag is full again. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then please give this video a thumbs up. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Please like, share, comment, subscribe, and all the jazz. I'm losing my train of thought. But please do subscribe, hit the notification bell, because we are so close to 10k subscribers, and I am like, I cannot believe that I'm so close. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one. Till then, bye. So I've used this in combination with the D3 anti-dandruff. Sorry. Retake.